Christy. I'm the Theorbo player for the Trio Pickleleet. And I'm here to explain a little bit about our program and how it was developed, Sozut the Pine. So, Pickleleet, as you might know through our earlier material, started out and we recorded some music in March, April, and May of last year. And the idea was to find pieces that worked for us to get to know each other as musicians and to develop some kind of chemistry within the group. Once we had done that, we had a wonderful time. The results were very, very nice. And the idea was to expand what our group could do and what we wanted to do. And one of the ideas amongst us was to try and tell a whole story through assembling different pieces that we liked or that fit the meaning we were after. And so we started looking for music. And we had, with this era, 16th century, 17th century, 18th century, finding material is not a problem. There are huge amounts from Monteverdi, Bononcini, Merula. If you stay just in Italy, it is enormous. So we were looking and looking, and we started to find pieces that we really, really enjoyed. And then we were able to kind of make what you'd call a musical skeleton. We were able to find one piece, and then find another piece, and then another piece. And then we had to make the tissue between those pieces. So we'd look for other pieces that kind of move the story along. So we found some wonderful music. We also found some music by some very unknown composers, some very, not anonymous composers, but composers that are not well known today. Hizzolo is one that we use that is beautiful music and is one of the first monodic composers. He's not very well known. It's very much at the beginning, slightly before Monteverdi. But it's incredibly wonderful music. So we were able to take some of those, and we were able to build almost a full story from beginning to end. There were several areas, several holes in the story, because there are certain subjects that are very hard to find something that actually fills that void in the story. So our story is about someone who's in love with someone and then slowly realizes that it's not going to be, so she goes through grief, she goes through anger, she goes through frustration, and then at the end she resigns herself to what is happening. So our music, we had some gaps where we had to get from one emotional state to another. And we were incredibly fortunate to be able to work with Larissa Verhoef, who's a wonderful poet, and she was able to make some poetry for us that was able to connect these parts and make the flow of the story just work seamlessly. And some of the poetry that she did, I actually took that poetry and composed some pieces to keep the music flowing, which was very, very nice, but in a way, very, very difficult, because the one thing I want with Pickleleet is for it to be the music of a certain time to fit. And so we don't want to have Bononcini and Jacopo Peri and then Stravinsky and then Monteverdi. So it has to kind of fit within the time that we're after. So I was able to put some pieces together to write some music to use the wonderful poetry that Larissa gave us. So right now we're developing it for our grand tour at the begins the end of May and will go through June. We're going to be taking this all over the Netherlands, which is going to be a really wonderful experience. And it's going to be something that is very unique, because for Trio Piccoli, for our ensemble, not only the combination of violone and theorbo and soprano, which is a very unique combination, but also the music that we do and the music we were able to put together is going to make it a very singular and exciting production, and we hope you enjoy it very much.
Dutch.
So the poetry that Larissa wrote was in Dutch, because she's the stad poet of Ada. So this will have actual compositions and poetry in the Dutch language, which will be something that's very unique. If you think of Dutch songs, you have Constantijn Huygens, you have some early operas, but even composers, there are composers in the Netherlands who were writing madrigals. There's one in Leiden at the end of the 16th century, and everything is in Italian. So even Dutch composers tended to write in Italian or French. And we will have music that is actually in Dutch that will work very, very well, and it will be something that you'll very rarely get to see.